Cincinnati woman was killed, her husband critically injured when troopers say a vehicle going at full speed slammed into their car at a stoplight. Investigators believe the driver who hit them was highly impaired. Tonight, Alejandro Correa is in jail facing DUI manslaughter charges. WESH 2'S Dave McDaniel is live at the intersection of World Center Drive and State Road 535 where that violent collision occurred. And Dave, did troopers talk to that driver?
Well, they did talk to the driver, and they were actually very surprised that apparently he did not realize that there had even been a crash. Here's the way they describe it. They say that the couple was sitting at the red light on the other side there, facing this way, legally stopped at that red light when this 20-year-old driver came up behind them and plowed into them, pushing them all the way across the intersection before coming to rest right there. In the light of day, it's easy to see where the wreckage came to a violent stop. Troopers said the Toyota was pushed 200 feet by the driver of the Dodge Charger, accused of rear-ending the couple at 12:30 in the morning.
There is nothing this driver could have done to avoid this crash. He's sitting at the light, following the law, waiting for the light to change, and had no idea what was coming up behind him.
The driver, 30-year-old Benjamin Frias, was critically hurt. He was rushed to the hospital. 24-year-old Giselle Batista was killed. Troopers say Frias and Batista were husband and wife. 20-year-old Alejandro Correa apparently wasn't clear why troopers were talking with him.
The driver did not even realize he had been involved in a crash. He thought he was actually being stopped by a trooper.
And yet he had hit a car, you say high rate of speed, any idea?
We don't have any preliminary speeds yet, but the cars were demolished and a very high rate of speed when this impact occurred.
The victims in the Toyota had to be cut out of the car. Neither Batista or Frias were wearing seatbelts. Correa was taken to the hospital before he went to jail because he had a minor injury. Troopers took blood from him, but arrested him for DUI manslaughter and vehicular homicide, even without an official lab result.
This was a severe crash and not just a fender bender. And for him to not realize that he had been involved in the crash is a definite sign of possible impairment.
And again, Correa's at the Orange County Jail right now. He's being held on just over $10,000 in bond. He declined a request for an interview. He is scheduled to go before a judge tomorrow morning. Reporting live in Orange County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.